It cannot be considered a gift to peer into the warp and unravel the possibilities of the futures that are, that might be, and that must be prevented. Nor can the burden of a weapon that each of my brothers looks upon with girded revulsion be called a gift. No, Master, I do not think my psychic prowess a gift, but a tool. Whether by a quirk of fate or the will of the Emperor, I possess a weapon the like of which can turn the tide, not just in a battle, but in the course of history. To withhold it, to flinch from its use or deny it, would not just be counterproductive, it would be heresy. But if it is a gift, it is a cruel one. Varro Tigurius serves as the chief librarian of the Ultramarines during the 41st millennium. Once a quiet and well-mannered boy, Varro's parents surrendered their intelligent yet awkward child to the guardians of the fortress of Hera. Knowing his innate talents could benefit the 13th, little could Varro's parents know the legacy of glory and valor that their son would forge. Prodigiously skilled in the arts of the librarian, even at such a fledgling state, epistolary zephyrs believed the upstart Tigurius to somehow be cheating his way to success. Bringing his suspicion to the supervising junior chaplain of the trials, Ortan Cassius, the pupil of Chaplain Phelan devised a trial of unwinnable odds to test the aspirants. Tasking the aspirants with loading bolter rounds into weapons disassembled and refitted with breaches too small to chamber such ammunition, Tigurius watched his competitors fumble to no avail. Confronting Chaplain Cassius, Varro stated unflinchingly into the eyes of Orton's skull-faced helmet and declared the challenge to be impossible. Verbally assaulting the youth with shouts of indignation augmented by the voximeter of his helmet, the deafening bellows of the chaplain did nothing to shake Tigurius's calm. Kneeling before Ortan until his tirade subsided, the chaplain's test had been passed. Laughing out loud and raising the young boy to his feet, Ortan Cassius simply remarked, "You will do." As time passed, Varro continued to climb through the ranks of the Librarius, his perception at a superhuman level belying the view of his superiors that Tigurius bore the rare gift of foresight to which none of their chapter had ever exhibited. Drawing suspicion by the more skeptical of his peers, the slights against his character swiftly subsided as his continued prowess in battle saved the lives of his kinsmen. Though among the most senior-ranking warriors of the chapter, Tigurius, by virtue of his gifts in manipulating the warp, alienated him from truly becoming a brother amongst his peers. Matching the tactical acumen of any captain of the chapter, despite his novitiate rank, his forewarning of the scout company during the Altor Crusade prevented their ambush by Eldar pathfinders. Personally preventing the death of Captain Agaman by insisting he forestall his armistice talks with the Eldar Autarch of the campaign, their counter-ambush of the striking scorpions lying in wait of the jungle foliage were burned to cinders by the flames of several Land Raider Redeemers. Appointed to the 5th Company, the Wardens of the Eastern Fringe, Varro's strike force were tasked with facing the 7 Sorcerers of Harka. Devising modifications to his psychic hood with aid from the chapter's artificers, such ingenuity allowed him to cast a wall of balefire during his battle against the 7 Chaos Space Marine Sorcerers. Dubbing this marvel of ingenuity as the Hood of Hellfire thereafter, none among the Ultramarines dared to besmirch the honor of Tigurius following their successful campaign. Promoted from the rank of Lexicanium to Codicia, Varro's accounts compiled from his successful battles and installed within the archives of the Fortress of Hera are a boon to the insight of future generations of Astartes. His time spent as a Codicia short-lived, as an epistolary of the chapter, only one rank remained for this psychic savant, Chief Librarian. Guiding entire companies of Space Marines during several system-wide campaigns, his actions during such battles would be summarized by the late Captain Saul Invictus as the greatest administrator the Munitorum had never known. Crucial in preventing casualties during naval warfare, Varro's foresight envisioned the strategies and maneuvers of his foes, long before they had been committed. Forming immense bonds of gratitude with the admiral of the fleet of Ultramar, Laszlo Tiberius, the naval officer attributes much of his success to the librarian. Ascending to the rank of chief librarian, the invaluable champion of the Ultramarines chapter could only be denied mastery of the librarius for so long. Burdened with intense responsibilities to use his powers in service to his chapter, his duty to preserve the lives of his kin, no matter the cost, would be epitomized by his actions in sacrificing his dearest friend, Sergeant Orestus, to save the lives of a dozen battle brothers and millions of innocents during the Hallowed Stars cleansing. Studying the vast library of Ptolemy within the Temple of Correction for guidance, the solemn contemplations of the chief librarian as he stared upon the shrine of the Primarch, regardless restored his heavy heart. Invaluable in combating the Tyranid menace during its many invasions of the Ultramar system, Varro's rumored delving into the consciousness of the Great Devourer gave him insight into the methods and tactics used by this terrible foe. Burdened with immense psychic might, there are few psychers of the Astartes imbued with power enough to rival Tigurius' abilities. Retrieving the Force Staff once wielded by the Sigillite during the Battle of Andraxis of 922.M41, the relic of Malkador the Hero inspires its new custodian to defend the Imperium from threats both brazen and clandestine in nature. Witness to the revival of the Avenging Sun during 999.M41, his counsel to the Lord of Macrag, Marneus Kalgar, was crucial in restoring his form. Though Varro bore the gift of foresight, even his strategic brilliance paled in comparison to his genesire. For with the Avenging Sun reinstated as the ruler of Ultramar, the enemies of the Imperium trembled. Present during the coronation of Rabute Gilliman, Tigurius for the next 7 solar months fought beside his Primarch in their reclamation efforts to cleanse their empire of chaos taint. Gilliman ventured to the throne world of Holy Terror to meet with his father, the Emperor, for guidance, whilst Tigurius, Chapter Master Kalgar, and Severus Agaman continued their mission to reclaim Ultramar. Falling into a comatose state with the birth of the Great Rift across the void, the psychic backlash of the tear in real space wrought untold suffering across the galaxy. Refusing to perish from the shock of this eruption of psychic trauma, Tigurius returned to his duties in defending Ultramar during the onslaught of the Death Guard Legion. Stealing the Ultramarine Auxilia's willpower during the most devastating days of the Plague Wars, the Chief Librarian staved off the darkness until his Primarch returned. With an army of Primaris Space Marines by his side, the Avenging Sun cast back Mortarion and his fettered abominations, yet Tigurius, for all his might, knew he must grow stronger. Crossing the Rubicon Primaris and transforming into a Primaris Space Marine, Varro Tigurius takes to the field imbued with power beyond his already Goliath former pedigree. His responsibility to guard the Ultramarines from threats both material and immaterial in nature ever necessary, the Chief Librarian continues to collate, compile, and combat the threats to the Imperium with stoic and wise resolve.